Hello everyone, I am Arushi of BCom Semester 4 of Hansraj Mahila Mahavidyalaya, Jalandhar. And today I am here to present a seminar on the topic Sixth Sense Technology. But before I begin, I extend my deep gratitude, appreciation and trustworthiness to our beloved Principal Ma'am, Dr. Professor Ajay Sareen. And I also thank our teacher in charge, Mrs. Binu Gupta Ma'am, whose scholarly outlook and excellence, constructive criticism and friendly approach helped me in the completion of this project. So, let us begin with the topic Sixth Sense Technology. It's the beginning of a new era of technology where engineering will reach new milestones. Just like in the science fiction movies, where display of computer screen appears on the walls, commands are given by the gestures, the smart digital environment which talks to us to do our work and so on, these will be possible very soon. You imagine it and sixth sense technology will make it possible. Isn't it futuristic? Now, it's time for the directors of science fiction movies to think ahead, because the technology shown in their science fiction movies soon will become household stuff. Few years back, it was considered to be supernatural, but now it has been made possible, thanks to Pranab Misri, a genius who introduced mankind to this futuristic technology. Now, let us take a look at the contents that we are going to discuss today. Introduction, components, how it works, applications, advantages and conclusion. First is introduction. So, Sixth Sense is a wearable gestural interface that enhances the physical world around us with the digital information and lets us use natural hand gestures to interact with that information. Gestures are basically motion of hands or body to express a thought or feeling. Sixth Sense technology was developed by Steve Mann in 1994 and further developed by Pranab Misri in 2009. So basically, Sixth Sense bridges the gap by bringing intangible digital information out to the tangible world and allowing us to interact with this information via natural hands. It associates technologies like recognizing hand gestures, capturing the image, processing the image and manipulation, etc. So this is Steve Mann wearing a camera plus projector dome in 1998. The camera used to capture an object and the projector used to display the same object on a surface like a wall. And on the right side you can see our Pranab Misri, one of the most powerful digital Indians, wearing a similar device in 2012. So these are the pictures of Steve Mann in 1994 wearing a headphone gesture based computing apparatus which was invented, designed and built by him. So he used a finger pointing gesture to outline and select a physical object. As you can see, he outlined a lamp. The outlining of the lamp was captured by the camera in the headphone apparatus. Next are the components. So the hardware components are coupled in a pendant-like wearable device. They are camera, projector, mirror, smartphone, and color markers. First up is camera. The camera captures an object in view and tracks the user's hands gestures. Then it sends the data to smartphone. It acts as a digital eye. Then is projector. The projector displays the object captured by the camera on any surface, which may be another object, wall or even a person. Then is mirror. As the projector's rays drops pointing downwards from the neck onto the mirror further reflects the captured image on any surface. Then is smartphone. The smartphone should be connected to the internet as it processes the video data. Color markers. It is at the tip of the user's fingers. Marking the user's fingers with red, yellow, green and blue tape helps the webcam recognize the gesture. So, here it is shown how Sixth Sense technology works. Firstly, the gestures that we make by our hand are captured by the camera. The camera then sends the captured image to the smartphone for processing. The smartphone further sends the information to the projector. The projector projects the image on the mirror and the mirror lastly reflects it on the desired surface. We all are a big Tony Stark fan, a character played by Robert Downey Jr. in the movie Iron Man. So you must have seen how a digital screen pops up in the air in the movie. That is also done by the use of Sixth Sense technology. Next are various applications of Sixth Sense technology, that is how we use it in our daily life. First is capture photos with fingers. Using the fingers, the user can capture photos. The box created by the fingers act as a frame for capturing photos. Second, palm is the new dialer. This technology enables the user to call without using the dialer. The dialer will be projected on palm and the user can dial that number using the other hand. Third, check your flight status. Just place the ticket in front of the projector and it checks its status from the internet. Fourth, clock. The user just needs to make gesture of clock and the watch will be projected on the user hand. Fifth, video newspaper. Like the video newspapers of Harry Potter, this technology identifies the news headlines and then projects a relevant video. Sixth, access anywhere internet. By this, the user can browse internet on any surface, even on the palm. Next are the advantages. First is, it is portable. That is, it can be easily carried due to its perfect size as we can carry it on our neck. Second, it supports multi-touch and multi-user interaction. Third, it is cost effective. Fourth, it connects intangible world with the tangible world. Fifth, it is an open source. That is, people can use it according to their needs and imagination. Last up is conclusion. This technology has seamless applications. This can be used as a replacement of the five senses for handicapped people. So, considering it as widespread applications, the inventor Pranav Mistry has decided to make its software open source. This would enable individuals to make their own application depending upon needs and imagination. As this technology will emerge, maybe some existing devices and technologies will be discontinued, but one thing is guaranteed, it will write a new chapter in the history of science and technology. Thank you.